vendo pra, tá vendo pra, tá vendo futebol, tá vendo pra casa.
Don't you start. Welcome everybody to Football Brasilia, going a little bit old school on the new World Cup, as over the next few weeks we bring you everything you need to know about the Copa do Mundo and England's chances in it. Here's what's coming up in this edition. Roy Hodgson says, welcome to the jungle. We find out what Brazilians really think about England's chances and Brazil, Maracanã. Let's get England icon John Barnes to tell us about that goal. But first, here's England manager Roy Hodgson to tell us what life may be like in the Amazon Basin.
We know it's going to be hot and humid in all of the places we play. We know the pitches will be slightly different, you know, with the grass, but we'll have plenty of time to practice on that. And of course, we know that the expectations and the emotions are going to need to be dealt with as well, because it's going to be an exceptional World Cup, because you rightly say it's in Brazil, which is, you know, one of the iconic footballing nations.
Roy and his boys. Now, who's the most famous Liverpool left winger since Derek Hatton? Who scored the greatest ever goal at the Maracanã? Who rapped on the greatest ever World Cup song? It is, of course, John Barnes. John, nice to see you.
Good to be here.
Do you know, it's almost 30 years to the day since you scored that goal. When you first took that, took the first touch that afternoon, did you think that three decades later you'd still be here talking about it?
It's strange, because looking back at it, and I see it a lot now because people show me, I always liked it to have an out-of-body experience, because I don't remember, I know it's me because I'm seeing me doing it, even with the tight shorts and the long hair, I know it's me. However, I don't remember doing any of that, because you're just reacting to people in front of you. So the only two things I remember in it was the final bit when I just put it in the goal after beating the keeper, and halfway through, I was about to shoot, and Tony Woodcock was in the way. So I had to then, instead of shooting, I had to check inside. And if you look, he actually jumps up thinking, I'm going to shoot. And I suppose the Brazilian defenders thought I was going to shoot as well, so they moved out of the way. I thought I was going to shoot as well, so... Looking at it, it looked better than it actually felt. It felt a little bit more nerve-wracking than that.
Oh, it looks pretty special. The funny thing is that most of the England squad weren't even born when you did that, sorry to say. Yeah. It's a really exciting mix of youth and experience. What do you think about it?
Well, it's exciting for the young players. I don't think the mix and the balance is right, because most international teams have and always have had the majority of their players aged between 23 and 29 with good experience. We don't have that a lot. We've got good players over 30. And we've got good players under 21. So we haven't got that balance right, which is nobody's fault, because Roy can only choose what he has.
Okay, how far do you think England will go in this World Cup?
I think we can get to the quarterfinals. I think if we get through the group, we've got a great chance of getting to the quarterfinals.
All right, and then in the quarterfinals you face?
Brazil or Spain. And can we beat them? Yes. Will we beat them? Probably not. But, you know, as I said, if they get through the group, I'll be happy. And if we get to the quarterfinals, I'll be ecstatic.
All right, who do you think will be the overall winners?
I think Brazil will win. The South American teams are much stronger than the European teams. And Brazil's home form will mean, I think, Brazil will win.
Well, thanks very much to John Barnes. And now let's take a look about what they're saying in Brazil about England's chances in the World Cup. First of all, UOL, who saw the game against Peru, they weren't all that impressed. Typical long ball game, and a chicken from the goalkeeper make England beat Peru. Chicken from the goalkeeper means a cock-up, effectively. It's a poultry reference. They did like Daniel Sturridge's goal, though. The same website also ran a survey of 51 Brazilian journalists about who was actually going to win the Cup. 36 of the 51 said Brazil, 7 said Germany, 2 said Spain, 1, bless, said England, but absolutely none of them said Argentina, which isn't a great surprise, I suppose. Who are England? Well, Ogier, the day, explained to their readers that it is a nation in transition, a mixture of youth and experience. That's you, Frank. Looking to end 48 years of fasting. All right, perhaps not you. They say Roy Hodgson has got a good blend of players to play with. They're very excited as well about England coming, because it is the inventors of football coming to the land where best the game has been perfected. It is the creators against the creations. Croatians, they're also in Group A, of course. Not everybody, though, thinks England are getting out of their group. Sierra 2014 say Group D is the group of death. They say the two teams coming out will be Italy and Uruguay. England, they say, will get knocked out. Mind you, they also call our manager Roy Rodgson, giving him an extra R, so they may well be talking out of theirs. And that's what they're saying in Brazil. Well, that wraps it up for this edition of Football Brasilia. Next time out, we're going to be looking forward to the big crunch game in Manaus between Italy and England. No, we're having a Brazilian to tidy things up. From all of us here, then, it is until then. Até mais.